In 1971, if you were the librarian at the public library in Hokitika and the whitebait were running, you could get the afternoon off to set your nets. Unfortunately, not anymore. But this is something I learned when I interviewed the former head librarian of the Hokitika Public Library as part of my 18-month stint here as a digital discovery librarian at Western District Library. Kia ora, I'm Mike Dickison, and I want to talk about what I've done over the last 18 months at a small public library on the West Coast. Now, my job was as a digital discovery librarian, along with Rohine Coakley, my colleague in the NZLPP program, who was a community outreach librarian and worked on improving the library's access and outreach to particularly to the Māori community in Hokitika. I was concerned with community access to our collections and to making things available online. And the first thing I did when I walked into the library was take this photograph. We have the most number of translations of the luminaries of any library in the world, I think. And so being a good Wikipedian, I promptly put them all into Wikidata and improved the luminaries in Eleanor Catton article. Then I noticed in the history room we had a locked cabinet full of obscure local publications and pamphlets that really weren't accessible to anyone. And I wondered what I could do to try and make this collection both able to be handled and issued and readable by more people. So I began to scan and produce facsimiles of some of the works so that at least we had clean copies that people could touch. But this wasn't really improving accessibility. So I then decided that we'd try digitizing out of copyright, I have to be clear, public domain works using Wikisource. Now, Wikisource is a Wikimedia Foundation platform that lets volunteers transcribe and proofread books that can then be made available for download or even exported as an EPUB. And you can see some of the stuff that we've already managed to complete. We have lots more in the pipeline, and we've just received a Matatui Foundation grant to continue this work for another 6 months. A volunteer sees this when they're working in Wikisource. It takes two people to clear and proofread each page. It goes yellow first, then when two people have checked it, it goes green, at which point the book is finished and able to be exported. Now, a tip that, by the way, you might appreciate, when you're looking through Google Books at an already scanned work, which is unavailable because Google thinks it's still in copyright, you can query them on this. So this Ivy Lord died in 1941, so his work is in fact in the public domain, even in America, which has a 70-year term. So what you can do is click on the contact and query that, say, I'd like to see the entire book and I believe it's in the public domain. Google will ponder that and get back to you in about 2 or 3 days saying, yes, you're quite right, this is in fact a book, our mistake. Then the whole book preview is now readable and downloadable, not by you, but by everyone. So good tip to know. So when we'd cleared these books, transcribed them and produced them as ebooks, we were able to put them up into Overdrive collection where, because they popped up as new books, they were immediately seeable and borrowable. In fact, we've had far more loans from these books in the last few months than they have had in their 10 years on the shelves. So I documented this whole process in a blog, Digital Westland, which I set up to try and give tips on Wikisource, tips on clearing copyright, dealing with Google Books, all this sort of stuff. I strongly recommend setting up a blog to document your time if you're ever in a short contract like this. The whole thing's exported and now available from the website. And one of the things I ended up writing about was a history of Western District Library based on our archives, news clippings and photos. Again, if you have a photo collection, make sure you write down the names of everyone, at least on the back. So we began recruiting volunteers to do some research and work with Wikisource. Here's some of our volunteer team, and Helen on the left there is now actively scanning Victorian engravings and line drawings from old reference books and uploading them to Commons where we can use them in Wikipedia articles. It's been a great success. So because we started getting involved with Wikipedia in the community, we decided to host New Zealand's first ever Wikipedia conference in Hokitika last year. And it was a small but passionate meeting, and lots of great stuff was done. And the great thing about Hokitika is that if you have a conference, you can have a bonfire on the beach afterwards perfectly legally. That's a tip to note. One of the projects I was working with was that with the Left Bank Art Gallery on West Coast Artists. This is Marilyn Remenzies, who's a weaver and painter from Westport. And we got photographs of her and her work copyright cleared by her so that they could be shared and reused under an open license, unlike most artwork photos. That means they were able to be used in a Wikipedia article, particularly this one here, which I wrote about her and several other artists, which we are now using as part of a Left Bank project to showcase and spotlight some of the work of West Coast artists, which is again an ongoing funded project now. And another thing I managed to do was run a community event in Barrytown, north of Greymouth, where locals contributed photographs, historic photographs of the town. And I wrote this entire article on the area, which is actually threatened by mining now. So that was a great community initiative, which we have to had to shift online at the last minute because of COVID, but still worked. And here's us in COVID. My wonderful team, I just want to thank them all for their support and their good cheer. And in a small library, you really depend on the quality of each individual team member. And it was so nice to work with these people. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.